Well, joining me live is US politics expert Dr. Jennifer Walsh from the Hawaii Pacific University. Great to see you, and some great analysis that we just saw there on the CNN presidential debate. Joe Biden seems adamant to continue to run as president. How do you think the Democratic Party is dealing with the negative reaction, including hearing numerous comments that he needs to step down?
Well, let's be honest. It was a disastrous performance by Biden, and it's caused great uncertainty about whether Biden can even last through his first term, much less be in a position to get another 4 years. What we are looking at is unprecedented. We've never had a candidate this old before. Clearly, he was showing some real cognitive struggles yesterday on the stage. And even if going back and looking at the State of the Union address, which was his last primetime appearance on March 7th, there seems to be a marked decline between March and last night. One of the things that we're clear about, the most important power of the president is the power to persuade. Not only does he have to persuade voters to back him, but he's got to persuade party leaders to go along with an agenda. And right now, Biden's most important job is to try to convince and persuade his own party to keep him on the ticket.
Should Joe Biden have been put in that position in the first place, do you think?
Well, I think there were some serious calls behind the scenes last summer when they were approaching the start of the election campaign season. He seemed to rally to the challenge. There were a lot of supporters who thought that a change of an incumbent out would be unthinkable and unwise, and they really did perceive Trump to be vulnerable. And in any other election, he probably would be. You know, we didn't hear a lot from Trump in terms of his vision for the next 4 years. It was a lot of, you know, mudslinging back and forth, which is not uncharacteristic nowadays. But the vulnerabilities that Trump might have otherwise persuaded voters to consider now have gone out the window. Last night was just terrible for the Democrats.
How do you think the moderators performed?
I think the moderators in CNN did really, really well. I know there's been some concern about they weren't interrupting to do fact checking, but I think, you know, that has always been a problem when you've had moderators insert themselves into the debate itself. The format seemed to work really well to showcase what we want the debate to do, which is highlight the candidates and their positions and the themes that they are going to be touching on during the rest of the campaign season. So I think it was a difficult job, no matter who you are, but CNN ended up looking like the winner, if you will, of this particular matchup.
Certainly some fact checks from various organisations. Were you surprised on how many false claims and exaggerations there were?
No, I mean, this has been standard fare for candidates over the last couple of years. Trump is known to be hyperbolic in pretty much everything he says, so not a huge surprise that some of the things that he was sharing didn't actually match up with historical fact or record. But again, I don't think anyone was terribly surprised by that. What people were counting on is for Biden to be more forceful in pointing out those inaccuracies or pointing out the historical record. And of course, Biden was just struggling to get sentences that made sense. So it was very damaging in terms of a lost opportunity. But again, it shifted the focus away from Trump and his particular vulnerabilities and onto the credibility of Biden to live out his last term, much less be considered for another 4 years.
All right, we've got about 10 seconds to go. But moving ahead, we've got the Democratic and Republican conventions, the second debate in September. What will you be closely looking at?
Whether or not it will be Biden on that stage in September, it's very possible that we will see a change sometime between now and the convention of August. Biden will resist that pressure, but I think there's going to be a lot of serious conversation about getting him to step down voluntarily.
Dr. Jennifer Walsh, thank you so much for your time and expertise.
Thank you so much.